What is up, everybody? Back with another Starro video, and here we are for a Should You Summon. Now, you might be wondering, why does the screen look kind of off-centered? That is because, even though yesterday they posted the details for the new character, we're not going to use that because they're gross and they don't show percentages and anything like that. And I'm just saying, if a character does something crazy like deals 1,000,000% of attack to all enemies, you know, I'd be a little bit more inclined to summon for them over if they did, yeah, this 1% of attack, right? Percentages kind of mean a lot. So, boom, here we are on this website. I'll have a link in the description, and it has all of the juicy percentages. So, another thing, I've heard this character's name be pronounced about 20 different ways. So, if you're wondering why I'm not saying her name, that is why. I'm not going to sound like an idiot. Nope. I refuse. So, I am just not going to say this character's name. But, regardless of that, don't forget to like, subscribe, and let's get into the video. So, Wind Abundance. Very cool. Are they going to be better than the Wocha is the real question. So, of course, we have the Pride and True basic attack that does the same damage as the element she is, and it scales off of max HP. Love to see it, right? I don't know why the other abundance characters don't all have this, but I mean, you know, W, more damage. It's not going to do like barely anything, but it's something, right? Then let's go over her skill. Dispels one debuff, which is already pretty much essential at this point for a healer, from a single target ally and immediately restores the ally's HP by an amount equal to 21% of her max HP plus 560. At the same time, restores the HP of all allies that are adjacent to this target ally by an amount equal to 16.8 of her max HP plus 448. So it's like a blast, but for yourself, meaning there is going to be a little bit of, I guess, like team building. I'm trying to think of like a good explanation for it, like team placing skills with this team, as you're going to want to make it to where the person you're probably going to have to heal the most and the one that needs to be dispelled from debuffs the most is going to be in the second or third slot. That way you can heal the two allies on the sides, right? I mean, this is going to work always, but you know, you don't want to be putting your DPS, who you need to cleanse of debuffs, in the first slot, and then the character next to it's the only one getting healed, and then say like the third character is just not getting any help whatsoever. So that is something you have to think about. I'd be really, really intrigued if there was a boss that switches the placement of your team. I think that'd be pretty unique for some of these. It doesn't really make too much sense now, because Bailu technically, I guess, but it's like she'll randomly just heal people. This one is the first blast like team wide effect, right? So I'm curious to see if they will move them around in the future or do something to address that. Then her ultimate regenerates energy for all allies excluding this character by an amount equal to 20% of the respective max energy. At the same time, increases their attack by 40% for 2 turns. Good lord. It's not as OP as Tingen's, as Tingen gives far more energy, but 20% for everybody and an attack boost? I thought this was a healer. Holy crap. That's a nice ult. Only issue with this character is the ultimate not being a heal. Does kind of suck when you're in a sticky situation, but that ult is pretty nice. And then the talents, after using a skill, she gains sacrificial life lasting for 2 turns. This duration decreases by 1 turn at the start of her next turn. If she has sacred life when an ally's turn starts, or when an ally uses their ultimate, restores HP of the ally by amount equal to 4.5% of her max HP plus 120. At the same time, every ally with 50% HP or lower gets healed once. When sacrifice of life is triggered by allies, dispel one debuff from that ally. This effect can be triggered up to 6 times. Using the skill again resets the effect trigger count. So that's pretty good. The talent almost saves her in the sense of there's not a ton of healing going on. I honestly think she's not bad, right? She's not bad. Is she better than Luocha? I'm not too sure, right? Let me pull up Luocha really quickly. Alright, sick. We're here with Luocha. So, the skill, this flower, all that stuff, yeah, and then immediately heals versus dispel one debuff is the... is it the trace that does it? Yeah, one debuff from an ally. Okay. Here, let me read the rest of this first. Generally affect horror struck, the enemies will flee. 100% chance to reduce every single enemy attack by 25%. That's not too bad. And then her bonus traces are when her talent is triggered to heal allies, she regenerates one energy. That is a very... Wait, what's her ult again? Five... Am I blind? Oh, it's up here. Her ult is 140. Lorch is 142, right? No, it's 100. Okay. Interesting. One energy is funny. Chance resist crowd control debuffs increased by 35. Okay, Valstar... Gain sacrifice of life lasting for one turn. Oh, should we just get it? Yo, hold up. Luocha needs... What is this? I'm pretty sure it's just... Oh, I don't have Luocha, so this is why I'm, like, asking so many questions about him. He's just ult skill, kind of like Jingwu, right? And then you get the field. Oh, whoops. Not that one. What are her dupes? I'm curious what her dupes are, right? Normally, I don't really go over them and they should you summon, right? Because you really shouldn't be chasing dupes, honestly. Sacrifice of life produced by talent extended by one turn. And then all ally speed increased. Okay, that's pretty solid, actually. The second one, when ally struck by a killing blow, oh, they revive with 50%. This reduces duration by one turn, so I can only trigger two times per battle. Damn. Bailu's whole stick and just says, nope, fine. And then the three is, you know, whatever. Right, it's the ultimate talent. When healing a target ally via skill or talent, the less HP the target ally currently has, higher amount of healing will see the maximum increase by healing it's 80. That's not bad either. That, like, pretty much guarantees that you won't have, like, a super weak heal. You know, like, almost, I'm not saying heal the full every time, but, like, that's really nice. And then the last one is when healing a target ally, increase the target ally's damage dealt by 50% for two turns. Jeez. Healing a target ally. I'm pretty sure that means healing with the skill. Damn. What's Luocha's? At six? Oh, type res. Okay, so it's not bad. Damn. Really? 50%? 80% damage dealt for two turns? Hopefully that wasn't cut off when I was reading the first time. Damn. Huh, I don't know. I feel like Luocha has to be better though, because the whole like when they attack thing. Hang on. Starts or uses an ultimate. And then his is it's when they attack. 18 versus... Okay, so the Woj is definitely better in terms of healing, right? But all of which it does is remove debuff, like a debuff, right? As removes buff on his ultimate, I guess, but we haven't gotten to a point where that's like super useful yet. So the cleansing is nice. I like how Woj just has way better chance of not being CC'd, which is funny. 35 versus 70. But yeah, no, Luocha definitely is the better healer, but she definitely has more to work with in the form of a support role. I might have to summon because I think her and Ting Yun will be a pretty nasty combo. I might drop Fushuan off my team and just run her, like this character, right? Ting Yun, someone else, and with like Pila, Silver Wolf, and then Jing Lu. Just because the energy will be really nice. I should have a lot of, I mean, the 20% energy, that's like, the fact that it's, okay, the fact that it's AoE, it's everybody, is really nice. It does suck that it doesn't give her energy because she's 140. And the attack increase is also pretty nice. This is also nice because I can run this on my DOT team. Man, I'm not gonna lie, kind of just like a, like, I'm comparing her to Bailu, right? Because the revive and the whole, like, heal one character and it bounces around. But it's like a support Bailu, in a sense. She seems pretty good. I'm not gonna lie, if you don't have Locha, right? And you're running, like, Bailu, Natasha still, or just Natasha. If you only have Natasha, you pretty much are forced to summon, right? Because only having Natasha is so rough, right? I think if you have Lynx and Bailu, right? Those are the two I have. You can definitely make do. But if your only healer is Natasha, you kind of have to summon, in a sense. Do they show on the character preview? I know it's going to be, like, cut off. Do they show what her banner was? I remember it being not too great. Did someone in the comments show it? Down in here? No. Hang on, let me cut to the banner because I can't exactly remember it. All right, I got it. It was Donhang Asta Serval. Okay, so the banner is not too great. If you're summoning, you're definitely summoning for her. But regardless, like I said, if you are struggling and you're low on healers, and I'd say if you run Natasha as your second healer, definitely think about summoning, right? Unless you love Locha to death, like he is one of your favorite characters, you can save for him, but we don't really know when he's going to be coming, right? He could be in 1.6, 1.7. If they push him back, he could be like 1.8 even, because they skipped Jingyun for Silverwolf, right? So we have Jingyun, then the Locha, so that's at least two if they want to go back on schedule. But like I said, they could just skip Locha and just go straight into Blade Kafka, maybe. I think she's good. All right, I'm not saying she's a must summon, but I think she is a rather good healer. I still think Locha is better, though. I still think it's better. Honestly, I still think he, as a healer, will keep you alive a lot easier than she does, but she provides such a better, like, team synergy, right? The ultimate has a lot of energy. You almost don't need to have run double support. You could probably just run her, another support, and maybe like a sub DPS, right? Or another main DPS if you can get away with that, which is kind of nice. Well, let's see. I'll mess around. If I do pull her, I'll mess around with some teams and see like how good she really is. But I'm actually rather impressed, right? Light cone, right? Because I always go over light cone in these videos. Is decent, right? Increase the wearer's energy regeneration rate by 12. When an ally uses their ultimate, the wearer restores HP for the ally currently with the lowest HP by an amount equal to 10% of the allied heal's max HP, so just more healing. When the ally provides healing for an ally, increase the healed ally's attack by 2.4, affecting Sagaha up to 2 times, lasts for 2 turns. So pretty much just energy regeneration, more healing, gives whoever you heal attack. It's not awful. I feel like you just don't need the summon for abundance light cones because the 4-star versions are just good, right? Like, you can use them just fine. So personally, if you're summoning, unless this is like your favorite character, like your top 3, don't bother going for the light cone. Save your stellar jades. But yeah, no. Like I stand, if you're rocking Natasha on your team, it might be time for an upgrade. She's actually pretty good. Do note that Argenti, who is a Iridation physical unit, is going to be after this banner, and Silverwolf, which Silverwolf is a very high value character. Do keep that in mind. They are after this character, so if you are summoning, keep that in mind. But other than that'll be it for the video. Let me know what your thoughts on this character are in the comments. If you're summoning, do you think she's mid? Do you think the Locha's better? Do you think the Locha's finally been beaten as the best healer? Let me know in the comments, and of course, I'll catch y'all in the next video.